name is Bart.
And my name is Kacper. And welcome to Engineer in Forest.
Welcome in the next episode of Engineer in Forest. Another day of adventure ahead of us. Important, as not the most important thing in our laboratory, is multimeter. If you are looking for multimeter in reasonable money, with good parameters, a good choice will be 10 mark.
Yep.
Actually, we have the model 72-104-10. It's a multimeter with alternate selection. Sometimes, I think the forest is getting dark.
Yeah.
So maybe try the backlight.
Oh, yes. It has.
Oh, yeah. That's good. It's a very important thing for us. Also, it can be connected via RS-232 connection, and we can read 3.75 digits from it.
Yeah.
Do you know that we don't have to use oscilloscope for the duty cycle?
Wow.
It has it inside, actually.
Yeah, nice.
In most cases, however, we'll use it to measure the voltage, continuity, what's more, test diodes. I'm curious how it works.
Yeah, I'm curious too. Another important thing in the laboratory is a soldering station. We have an interesting instrument with a nice design. It is important that our soldering station has a power reserve. This model is just 80 watts, which is enough for most applications.
Okay, so here we have already unboxed and plugged it into the supply our soldering station. It has an adjustable digital screen where we can adjust our temperature, just like this, and also some short functions like here. To solder something into our plate, we'll also need some tin, some flux, and also times to times the solder remover.
Yeah, we have one board after resuscitation. Such boards are a real paradise to learn soldering. We warm up our soldering irons to a temperature of 350 degrees Celsius. We have to be careful about the temperature because some elements do not like too high temperature. There is nothing better than practice. Let's try to fix some boards.
So first of all, we have to check our fuses. Here we have one fuse. Yep, this one is good. Here we have another fuse. And it's also good. So for example, we can check also some capacitors. How to check the capacitors? Here we have one. So let's try. As we can see here, it's charging. And for this side, yep, it changed the direction and it's also charging. So that means that our capacitor is good. As we can see here, we have some exactly one diode. Let's see how it works. For this side, it's showing 0.4. Okay, it's good. For opposite side, it's infinity. So our diode is good. Okay. If you find, for example, a broken capacitor there in our board, we have to put some flux to this place. And also we have to use our solder remover wick. Okay, so here we have our broken capacitor.
Okay, so another interesting equipment is really beautiful device. Who thought that we would like to see this times the cable tie tool produced by Things Contact.
Yeah. Ergonomic tool for a single step, and also we have the infinitely adjustable tension force is indicated by scale in the handle area. When the tension force is reached, the reminder is automatically served for a flush finish. Yeah, let's see how it works.
Yeah, I'm curious as well. Yep, it's working pretty well.
Yeah.
You know, when we have, for example, 100 of those titles, it's gonna be really hard work to do this by hand, yes? So this device is pretty useful in our job.
Yeah, okay.
And I thought that we made an electric chair.
Yeah.
Fiber optics nowadays surround us everywhere, even here in the forest. But what happens when we want to tame our beam of light? To send information with a fiber optic cable, it must have a smooth front face.
Okay, so For this purpose, we can use polishing kit, Broadcom Limited. It's much cheaper and alternative than a grinder, which costs a lot of money.
Okay, so as an engineer, we are making a lot of projects. They only exist on the desk. And if you would like to close the project in a dedicated housing, you can order practically every exist shape and size from wide range of Camden Bros production.
Yeah, they are all available on fernal.com. And yes, Bartek, now you can use a hammer. Let's make a destruction test. Yeah, whoa. Enough. It's really hard to break it.
So I think it's really solid and we don't have to carry too much about our projects in this housing.
Yeah. Enjoy your time with aroma of flax. But remember, do not inhale this. It's a poison. In the forest, we have a healing breeze. But when you do it in the closed rooms, do not inhale fumes. Take this cardboard box and go. See you next time, guys.
Bye.